Hey guys, I'm LB, and I'm not very happy with my choices here. What is this goodness we're seeking to maximize? Either happiness, liberty, equality, wealth, basic goods like food and healthcare, all of the above, or I'm not in a position to solve these problems. I do not want to pick all of the above, I do not want to pick wealth, I do not want to pick equality, do not want to pick basic goods like food and healthcare. Liberty and happiness are both equally... well, they have solutions that would result in not having the other one. So you could have liberty without happiness, and you could have happiness without liberty. I am not in a position to solve these problems for sure, but we promised this guy we would talk to him. Philosophical problems. Alright, I'm probably gonna pick this, because... well... I'll just pick happiness. It's a classic, I'll give you that. Suppose you climb that tower and step into the utilitarian paradise. Unfortunately, your presence there offends a number of Puritans to such a degree that the total amount of happiness in the world would go up if you were killed off, and so justice demands your head. This is still signed so idyllic. Yeah, see, this is one of the problems that I was talking about. I knew that this would be something that would happen if I picked that option. Basically, no matter which option I pick, he would explain a scenario where it's a bad option to pick. It's as good as we'll get. No amount of happiness outweighs a life. Admit that happiness should be equalized. Well, currently we do have a justice system that can result in the death sentence, right? I guess it depends on how much you value life. These are all tough questions. On that, at least, you may be right. You know, there are shedloads of broken theories less ridiculous than the one you're chewing through. How about I give you a bit of space to consider them? Oh, and if the real world turns out to be everything you imagined, do me a favor and leave me here. Okay. Let's see, which puzzle do we need to go to? This one. Okay, so this is a shortcut out. Wait, which components did this have just now? Oops, come on. Cemetery. With a box and the lasers. Boxes and lasers. Oh, hello! Long time no see. Last time I saw you was Egypt. This is gonna be another puzzle where I have to sync them all up. Okay. That's not something that I can... Yeah, it's not something I can do right now. What if I just shorten this guy's path a little? Will that work? Okay. That should be decent, right? So first we'll intersect it, right? But then they'll be in sync from intersect- yeah, like that. That'll give it more time to do its thing. What about in here though? I'm curious. Ah, there's a box in here. And that guy does not come in here. Interesting. This box for. I think I'm gonna come here last. I need to go the other direction first. Box there. Take this. Okay, we'll use the box to block this guy for now. So there's that. Now, we want an angle on this. That works. Too. All right then. Thought I saw something. Okay, now we have two boxes, but I know why. I know why. So, take this, do that. That looks like it'll work. Stupid of me. I'm glad those things don't kill you. That would be very annoying. Do that. Yep, I think that was it, right? Yep, that was it. Okay. So, there is a star. We know where it is. It's in this puzzle over here. But the issue is, we don't know how to get to it. Alright, let's just leave for now. Okay, so that was one, that was two. So next we want three, right? Yeah, okay. Post437.html. Like everyone else on the internet these last days, I just wanted to say bye, and thanks for reading my little blog for so many years. It's been fun, hasn't it? So many deep conversations, so much philosophy. Okay, it was mostly cat pictures and bad puns, but still. I kinda regret spending so much time at the computer. Not when I was doing stuff, just all the sitting around, checking my emails a million times, reading pointless status updates by people I don't like. Didn't like. But I don't regret the friends I made here, or the laughs we had. You're all good people, and I'm glad I got to know you. Have a nice end of the world. What if one of them's a serial killer, though? Then they're not all good people. Okay, third thesis. It remains strange that the earlier generations seem to perform their toilsome labor only for the sake of the later ones, to construct for them a step from which they can raise higher the edifice that nature intended, and only the latest of all generations have the luck to inhabit the edifice that a long line of their ancestors unintentionally constructed, blah. As puzzling as this may be, it is equally necessary if one assumes the following. A species of animal possesses reason, and must develop this capacity to its perfection, being individually mortal, but immortal in the species. Humble brag. I have always known that God maketh his sun to rise on the evil and on the good, and sendeth rain on the just and on the unjust. But I must admit, it's one thing to know the words and another to truly understand them. Though I am certain my faith is true, that does not make me special or exempt from the suffering. I'm just another human being, and God has seen billions of us come and go. And I have to say, this is surprisingly hard to accept. I always thought I was humble, but now I'm realizing I was very proud of being humble, which is really dumb. I guess I'm not the first one to do that, huh? Oh yeah, something else I wanted to mention, when I was talking with the serpent earlier, he mentioned about my presence offending people. And that's a problem with society right now, people getting offended for, like, no reason, just because they want to be offended by things. You know when in school when kids tease you and you think it's like the end of the world because everybody's teasing you? But it turns out that it didn't really make a difference at all, it doesn't even matter that they were teasing you, the things they said aren't real facts. And even if they were real facts, it doesn't matter that they're teasing you about it. And then you grow up as an adult, and you learn that you could've just ignored all of it, and so you do ignore a lot of it. But then there are people who seemingly grow up, but then they don't learn how to ignore things, and then they just get offended by everything. Like, everything offends them, everything that doesn't even affect them offends them. I don't really understand why, but the thing is, you know, you would think, okay, so they get offended, what's the big deal? It doesn't bother you, right? Well, then they go and complain to you, and the complaining is what bothers people. It's a big paradox of being offended.
Sometimes I worry that the answers I embrace are too simple. Can we ever truly, fully understand the divide between our biology and our intellect? How much is nature, how much is nurture? If my intellectual capabilities and my knowledge were replicated in a machine, would that machine be me? Would it be human? And what would be more humbling to my ego? If the answer was yes, or if the answer was no? What if I'm making too many assumptions? But there's no time to worry about my ego now. There's work to be done.
Oh, that's interesting. What do we have here? I bet I could make that jump, but I wouldn't be able to do anything with it. Right? Is that inside a test? Interesting. But yeah, if they put my mind in a machine and just simulate my brain, that would still be me. It would just be another me. Play Soma if you don't understand. It seems my refusal to argue semantics with the computer has angered it, and it refuses to engage with me further. Elohim is pleased, which was not my intention. Elohim is pleased because you swallowed his claptrap. The voice of doubt is your only line of defense. Wait. Defense with a C? Is that right? I've always been confused about defense with a C versus defense with an S. Is defense with an S even a word? Am I just making that up? Alright, well this one has the box, so let's look at it. Cause this is weird. This seems like it would be how we get lasers out of here or something. This is an interesting environment. Ah, we've got windows. Alright. What happens if I drop the box? It won't let me. Okay, so we have the box. What's in there? Why would we want to turn that off with a laser? Like, why would we ever want to put anything in here? Why would we ever want to go back in there? Ever. I don't understand. Okay, so we need both things to activate it, but we can turn it off and on at will once we have the laser pointed at it. That's nice. Yeah, okay. How high does this send us up? Oh! Wow, this sends us up really high! We put a box on a laser. We could probably access it in there. Maybe even over there. I mean, put a laser on top of a box, sorry. Okay. So if we do that, then we can jam that. There we go. Man, a lot of falls to your death here. What's this area about? Oh, this is the end, apparently. Interesting. So, these actually require line of sight. I didn't know that. Well, maybe I did and I just forgot. But this. I can take this and put it there. That would do its thing. Yeah, that unlocks this, but now I can't get in here, is the issue. Oh, there's that. That would explain it. Thank you. There we go. Ta-da! That was a piece of information I was missing. Yep. Reach that, I wonder. I mean, I'm not really sure what we would use it for, but I just wonder if we can reach it. Not quite. Definitely too far. Alright, well, I'll just set the thing back up again, so that it's up in the air, and we might be able to reach it from another puzzle. Actually, we'll do this next episode, because I didn't realize we were over. So, as always, thank you for watching. If you hate the sound of my voice, leave a dislike. It's up to you. And I will see you all in the next episode. Goodbye!